Now hear the word of Yahweh as he speaks through his holy scriptures. But to this one I will look, to him who is humble and contrite of spirit, and who trembles at my word. Isaiah 66:2, the word of God. This Christian is radical, what's written is factual. Let me first establish all scriptures infallible. It's God breathed, his word he exhaled. To the blind, the spirit makes the text braille. Embrace his mysteries, look and take a glance at the greatest history book, no fate or chance. Cause his word never fails, unlike men who are sinning. By his word, he's declared the end from the beginning. And his plan of salvation is solely through scripture. God reveals himself, yet it's only a whisper. To speak to man, he's greatly condescended. But only his spirit can make you comprehend it. But we can't grasp the whole of it, it's impossible. Cause the fact is holy writ is inexhaustible. Yet you claim his word has contradictions. Cause you don't have the spirit and you're not a Christian. Imposters can't see it with binoculars. And only the canon's inspired, not the apocrypha. Ignoring the facts of it is horribly hazardous. And I can assure you that it's historically accurate. See, the text we hold is the Dead Sea Scrolls. And we testify that it sets free souls and renews the minds of these dudes who rhyme and fiends who use the fry and inject needles. Grass where the flowers fade, but the word of God endures forever. A perfect treasure. Grass where the flowers fade, but the word of God endures forever. A perfect treasure. Grass where the flowers fade, but the word of God endures forever. A perfect treasure. Grass where the flowers fade, but the holy word of God endures forever and ever.
Why the certain guys ignoring the fact that the Bible's the church's final authority? Black, my brothers, it is for sure. We call the Bible holy cause it's set apart from all other literature. And forget philosophy, his word has got to be the real. Cause it's the only holy book with prophecy fulfilled. I was a foul pagan, but mind you, I'm now Satan. How the word of God's made me wise to salvation. Meet the Savior on a piece of paper. See the glory of Christ, he's the creator. And each page has a really meaty flavor. So we should savor it, not say, I'll read it later. But make it a life and a great delight. Hide it in our hearts, meditating on it day and night. And be firmly rooted right next to Jesus. Using hermeneutics and tight exegesis. We should give God the glory. Preach expository while teaching kids like Montessori. Be diligent to adore it and fear it. Be killing sin by the sword of the spirit. Satan despises me, it angers society that we speak in a biblical language variety. Cause it reveals that mankind is sinful, but it revives the soul and makes wise the simple.
The word of God, observe his law. See our need for Christ, it shows we're surely flawed. The word of God, observe his law. See your need for Christ, it shows you're surely flawed.
Yo, instead of reading it, we sit and we watch the idiot box. Picking our crotch, fixing our thoughts on wickedest plots. Our culture's acted pitifully, and Satan uses the widespread lack of literacy. See, the world is deceptive, and it's horrid and wretched because of its man-made morals and ethics. Its subjective poop misdirects the youth, but God's law is the only objective truth. See, lots of men's conventions are smart, but only the word can judge the thoughts and intentions of the heart. And the word suffice to give eternal life, cause faith comes from hearing through the word of Christ. A call to all, and I'm not insulting y'all, but the spirit by the word saves without an altar call. And through it his sheep hear the voice of the shepherd. Once poisonous lepers, now rejoicing forever, saved by his healing tongue. The spirit of God uses the word of God to reveal the Son. Come consider this, we once were wisdomless, cause without the spirit the word's a bunch of gibberish. And without him you're still doomed with Satan, cause only he gives the words illumination. It's a sharp blade, it imparts grace and sparks faith, a lamp shining in a dark place. Christians always ask, what's God's will for me? Well, it's found in his word, search with humility. The man of God's equipped, there's no complications. The scripture's sufficient, apart from confirmation. According to the scriptures, Christ died in our stead. It's according to the scriptures that he rise from the dead. Our only thing that's tangible to focus on, Emmanuel. It's our rock and it's our hope and it's our holy manual.
Grass where the flowers fade, but the word of God endures forever. A perfect treasure. Grass where the flowers fade, but the word of God endures forever. A perfect treasure. Grass where the flowers fade, but the word of God endures forever. A perfect treasure. Grass where the flowers fall off, but the holy word of God endures forever and ever and ever.
All glory to
to Yahweh, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the incarnate Word, the Logos, Jesus Christ. For we have been born again, not of a seed which is perishable, but imperishable, that is through the living and enduring Word of God. Thank you, Father.